I'm trained and I have the tools to understand what are the physics law that regulate some of the things I see. So it could be like, I don't know, the water in a stream, for example. So that is like something that you can find in nature, but you can also find similar things in industrial applications. And in all cases, I can describe this phenomena in mathematical ways. And that helps because it's something that can be used together with additional techniques to predict how that object or that setting will behave in the future. And if you know that, you kind of have some information on how you want to design it in order for it to function in the way you want. My background is more on mathematics, but applied to the simulation. So applied to creating digital twins of products and to essentially understand digitally how a certain thing performs in the given conditions or in future conditions that might be created and so on. So for sure you can describe a design, let's say of a 3D object, in mathematical terms. You can describe the shape of it, but you can also describe the way this object will function in a certain environment. So if you know how to describe the object and how to describe the environment in mathematical terms, then you can essentially use mathematics to create a better design. So generative design is, I think, the next generation way of creating designs, either of parts or of systems or production systems and so on. And it combines learning from the past, what was done in the past, previous experiments, with like ways of simulating what a certain design will do once it is in action. So how it will interact with the environment. Combine these things together and be able to present a bunch of alternatives to the user that already meet the function that we're looking for.
Siemens, ingenuity for life.